Last week, Bokoto South Member of Parliament, Dr. Twaha Kagabo, went on to defy his party position when he attended the President's address to Parliament at Kololo Ceremonial Grounds. We have a one-on-one with him because he is the only National Unity Platform Party Member of Parliament to have attended that address. Honourable, why did you, out of all the 57 NUP MPs, defy the party position?
Last week, we happened to have a parliamentary sitting, not so indifferent from other sittings, only that the only aberrations from the sitting were that this time we had the President in the House, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. And they've not released our political prisoners. Two, for me, I know what the President will say. I'm privy to his speech. Three, they will always relieve us of our phones. May I hate that one. Four, there is always a lot of jam in Kololo. So those reasons could not convince me not to go and attend such a sitting, of which we are the most important beneficiaries, given that we generated the questions that the President had to respond to.
Don't you find there are reasons, for example, releasing political prisoners, legitimate reasons?
Any person, any Ugandan with a brain that does not have scars on it will never find a reason as to why these people never went into a sitting like this one.
So are you still in the new party?
A member will only renegade a party in the last year. You can only renege in your last year of the term.
Are you planning to do that?
No. We cross the road, we cross the bridge when we reach it.
Do you still have communication with the NUP leadership, the leader of opposition, the presidents of NUP?
Why do you want me to speak to them? Why don't they speak? Why don't you ask whether they've spoken to me? Because if you have a party secretariat has a structure. It has disciplinary, the section, the disciplinary unit, it has a rules unit, and everything for it to be a robust party. So the question, that question should go to them, that now Kagabo has aberrated from your norms. Have you summoned him? When are you summoning him? What was his response? Did he attend? And so on and so forth. That's the thing.
Do you attend their party meetings?
The party meetings. Yes, when it's optimal for me, I attend.
Now that you're still attending their meetings, is what you're doing backed by NUP?
Primary thing, the functional unit of my politics, of an MP's politics, is the constituency. Those people, what do they say? They are my bosses. What do they say? Then, other things I hear, friend, party, speaker, president, a secondary.
Considering the controversies you have had in this term with the party, will you seek the NUP party ticket in the next election?
The next election, why not? I told you these are societal things. It is incumbent on us and my leadership in the party to harmonize them. Let everybody understand that disagreements, especially on principle, should not be a basis to dig big rifts and clefts.
This week on Monday, there were opposition protests in Kenya. And going by what you saw there, do you think that you as opposition have an effective strategy to hold the NRM government accountable for their actions?
There is what we call geopolitics. Meaning that what happens in East Africa has got a very huge bearing on what happens in Uganda. What happens in Africa has a bearing on what happens in Uganda, but not absolutely. What am I trying to mean? That the peaceful demonstrations they are carried out, you see, are unimpeccable, unchallengeable, they are monumental. Everybody saw that. We've not recorded any deaths and whatsoever. Okay? So, likewise, if we are to adopt such, we have also to make sure that we befit in such a picture.
Thank you very much, Honorable. You have heard it from the horse's mouth. Until next week, I am Vivian Kamsimi.